everybody. I am coming to you today just sitting in my kitchen. I just thought that I would do another just sort of little vlog to post to my channel. Just kind of updating and I don't know, just talking, just blabbing, I guess. But for my new subscribers, I just wanted to kind of introduce myself. Obviously, you've probably watched a video or two, so you know that I have alopecia. I do have a hair loss video here. If you are a new subscriber and you haven't watched that yet, it's the very first video on this channel from over a year ago. So, but just real brief, I'm Lisa. I have alopecia areata. I've had it since, I keep kicking my light. I've had it since 2003. Started off with just patchy hair loss, ended up with total hair loss in 2017 due to a reaction actually to a treatment that they did for it, an allergic reaction. So just caused the rapid loss of my hair in 2017, October of 2017 actually. And so, oh, I just missed it actually. I think November the 2nd was my wig anniversary, which is kind of cool. So I've been wearing wigs officially for 2 years, since November 2nd of 2017. So so that's just a little bit about me, brief synopsis. I am so glad you're here. I thank you for watching my videos. I hope the reviews are helpful. But I also like to come on here every once in a while and just do a little vlog and just do a little chat and just kind of update on, you know, what's going on in the life of Lisa of Brunette Wig Place. And so I just had a couple stories and just some stuff like that to share with y'all. So first story is Saturday night, this past Saturday, my wig fell off. That has never ever happened. Like, I've had them slip back, I've had things like that happen before, never ever had one just go poof. So I was wearing this new wig that I just bought from Garda Wigs. It's a human hair wig, super cute. I've posted some pictures of it on my Instagram, but I haven't reviewed it yet. It's about the same length as this bob, but it's got waves, probably a little bit longer than this bob. This is Elite by Ellen Villa, by the way, synthetic wig. And so we were at this charity event and they had these cars sitting around. And so it was us and our really, really good friends. And so my friend's husband was like, you two sit, go sit on that Porsche and we'll take your picture. And so we sat down and, you know, like we sat down and I sashayed my head really, really hard. Ah! And the wig flew off, like went backwards. I caught it. I was so proud of myself because, like, we went to this same event 2 years ago when I first started wearing wigs. This event was the same event that we went to. We go to this event they have it twice a year in our area. It's called a sip and stroll. It's a wine tasting, food tasting, music, and it benefits a place called the Ballard House, which is a place where people who are from out of town can come in and when they're receiving cancer treatment. It's kind of like a Ronald McDonald House, but just for adults. So wonderful charity, great and really fun event, you know? And so, so this event, it was the first big event that I ever wore a wig to, where I wasn't like, where I was out in public around complete strangers, where I had to, you know, interact with, you know, food vendors and the wine people and just other people in public. You know, it was intimidating, but had to say my best friend was with me and they're the same people that we were with the other night. She is one of my biggest supporters, of course. So so she was super supportive and she just kept saying, you look great, your hair looks great, don't worry about it. And the wig didn't move, didn't slip, no problem, didn't have any problems with it, you know. And that was a big milestone for me because I was much more comfortable. It was like, okay, I made it through this event. I did this. Nobody said anything. I don't think anybody knew I was wearing a wig. I'm gonna be okay, I'm gonna be able to do this, you know. So that event was kind of, you know, monumental at the time and still is to me. So we go to this event, you know, a couple times a year. They hold it in the spring and they hold it in the fall. And so here we are at this event again. And of all the places, the first place my wig comes off is at this same event. So it was just kind of funny, but I was so proud. I was like so stealth. I mean, that thing, I flipped my head back and the entire wig came off. This particular wig fits my head perfectly. It's a petite average cap and it fits really, really well. But what I realized was I always like to wear a wig cap. I wear a nylon wig cap under all my wigs. So I don't know, it's just me. It's just a thing. Sometimes wigs will be just a little bit itchy and it eliminates that problem and things like that. So I think it's because I had the nylon cap on underneath. So I had that little barrier between my head and because the wig cap on this particular one has silicone on the inside. And so it's kind of made to be it's made to be a gripper cap. And like I said, it fits my head great, but I just flung my head too hard, you know, and I didn't have any kind of tape or anything like that. So what I learned is if I want to wear a wig cap with that particular piece, I'm just going to put a little tape, you know, on the lace. And I did that. I wore it the next night just to go out to dinner and I did that and I wore it like I wore it all day yesterday and it was super secure that way. So that's my solution if I want to wear a wig cap under that particular wig. So, but it flew off. I mean, it flew off, like it flew and hit the car. The back of the hood of the car, and my friend and I are dying. So I'm there, like in a wig, and only a wig cap, with my bald head. You know, because I have like a strip of hair here, a patch of hair back here. I've got that white vellus hair. I mean, my scalp is crazy looking. So I was just like, oh, and I just was super fast. And fortunately, it was kind of dark in the area. It was already, you know, since we've had daylight savings time. It's dark early, and this was probably about 8 o'clock, or no, I guess probably about 9 o'clock. So it was dark, obviously. So it wasn't like there were bing bright lights on us or anything like that. So I just grabbed that thing and put it back on my head, and the picture came out so silly. I mean, we just look ridiculous because I look like my wig just fell off, and my friend has her eyes closed. So I tell my husband, I'm like, yeah, all that for that picture. That's not really a very good picture. I'll insert it up here so y'all can see it. It was kind of funny, but. Anyway, so that's kind of a little adventure, and I just want to tell you, my wig fell off in public. I survived, okay? Nobody came running up to me and said, oh my gosh, I just saw your wig off your head, and I was thinking about it, I have to be honest. You know, we went, there's a restaurant, they have it in a little shopping, like a little open-air shopping center, and they set up all the booths, and then there's restaurants around there, so after the event, we always go and have a late dinner. And so we went to this one restaurant and there were people in there. And I have to say, it was kind of going through my mind, like, I wonder if any of these people saw me with my wig off, you know, did they see my wig come off? Do they now know I wear a wig? But then I just found myself saying, so what? If they know it, they know it. I mean, I don't have an alternative. I don't have hair that I'm gonna walk around in. So if it bothers you, whatever, get over it. You know, that's kind of my attitude. So I just was kind of proud of myself. I was able to just kind of laugh about it and not get freaked out about it, not want to run to the car and go home or anything like that. So now I can think of other instances where that could happen, where particularly if you were the center of attention or something like that, where I probably would have been a little more mortified by it. But anyway, I just thought I would share that with y'all because it was kind of funny and I survived. So. Other things I was gonna tell y'all about was just sort of, I know I've reviewed a whole bunch of wigs, and I just thought I would cover a few that are definitely my go-tos. As far as, you know, I'm sure that if you're on social media, if you're on Facebook, Instagram, you see me sometimes selling some of the wigs that I review. And so I purchase wigs on my own. Like I just said, I just purchased this Gardo wig. I also get wigs sent by companies. Companies approach me and they ask if I want to review a wig for them. And so, and this is what started me doing wig reviews, which I've covered before. Vogue Wigs sent me a DM and they said, hey, would you like to review for us? And I was like, sure, I'll try it, you know. So my whole goal with this YouTube and with my Instagram and everything is really just to be in touch with other wig wearers to give support and to get that support back, because believe me, that support helps me so much. Whenever y'all comment on my videos or comment on my Instagram or Facebook page, you know, just that, oh, that looks so pretty on you, or, you know, I appreciate the review, or that helps me so much, just that feedback from y'all. And I try to give more than I get. So it is a daily practice of mine to scan through, to go through my Instagram feed and, you know, give it right back, give the feedback back, and, you know, just remind people that I see wearing wigs and dealing with their hair loss that, you know, they are still beautiful and they look great in their hairpiece. And, or if they're wanting to know opinions, I'll give an honest, you know, if they want an honest opinion about one they're not sure of or whatever, you know, but I just try to give that feedback back. And, but I want you all to know that I appreciate it. It doesn't fall on deaf ears whenever you say, oh, you look so pretty in that, or great color on you, or whatever. I really appreciate, you know, your communication back with me about that. So, so some of the wigs that I get, I do sell. So if you ever see me review a piece and you want to know if I'm going to sell it, or if you see it, you know, pictures posted of it on Instagram or Facebook or whatever, it doesn't hurt to ask me, hey, are you going to keep this one or sell this one? Because I have had pieces that I thought I was going to keep, and somebody sent me a DM or just asked me, you know, in the comment section, do you want to sell this one? I sometimes will be like, yeah, sure, what the heck, I'll sell it, you know. Or there are pieces that I get that I'm pretty sure I'm going to sell, because I just have kind of a little, I think we all have this, we have a regular rotation of wigs that we wear, and if I don't feel like a wig is going to be one of my go-tos, then to me, I would rather sell it, because the wig is basically in new condition. It's only been on my head for me to put it on with a nylon wig cap underneath, do a review. A lot of times, the only time they've been outside is when I go outside to show you the color outside, and they are otherwise brand new wigs. So they're like an open box special, and I try to sell them at an affordable price, because part of what my mission here is to help people get affordable hair, you know? But I also, you know, appreciate the fact that these wigs are new and they do still have value, so I don't just give them away. I mean, I do sometimes give people wigs. I have done that before. You know, so look for those wigs, and don't be bashful about asking me if you see me review one, you know, hey, will you sell that? You know, because if you see one that you like I said, there's a good chance I might sell it to you. But if I don't want to sell it, I'll just be honest and just say no. But I'll, you know, that's all you're at risk of asking, is I might just say no, you know, or I might say I'm not sure yet. But whenever if you've asked me and I say I'm not sure yet, I'm going to be registering it in my mind. Oh yeah, this person was interested in this wig, and I might, you know, then message you a week or two later if I'm finding I'm not, you know, it's not becoming one of my go-tos. I just don't believe in having these wigs sit in my closet in boxes. I mean, I want these wigs to be worn. I want y'all to try them. So that's why I sell them. So that's that. I sell on Facebook in the Wig Studio One group. Selling is allowed on Sundays. And I sell on Flip Your Wig and Beautiful Wig Tag Sale group. Those two groups are the only two groups that I'm in. I have sold some on eBay, but I find that wigs on eBay take forever to sell. So I'm kind of losing interest in selling there. So it's funny, because I have had ones that sold like a hot cake, you know, and then I've had others that I'm like, why is nobody buying this wig? Like, this is a great wig. So eBay, not so much. So that's that. So as far as wigs, I'm looking at my notes to make sure I cover everything, because I don't want to talk too long. As far as wigs that I have been wearing a lot, this is a great example. This is Ellen Villa Elite in the color Chocolate Rooted. This is one of my big go-tos. I'm wearing just, you know, sweats and stuff. I'm about to go to the grocery store and I need to run to Ulta. And so I throw this bob on all the time. I wear it several times a week. It's comfortable for me to wear around my house. It's just a great piece. Really, really love this one. Another one that I really love is my Caliente by Beltress in English Toffee. I love that wig. It's so pretty. And I have to say the fibers, those Beltress heat-friendly fibers are doing great. I have not had to heat treat them or anything. I've washed it, I don't know how many times. I've washed it several times now. It's washed, you know, it's washing great. It's just a great wig. Another one that I'm loving is that Jon Renau Allison in Cocoa Bean. I'm wearing that cute bob a lot. That bob is very chic. It's fun to wear. It's great for daily wear or great for, you know, going out at night. And then I love my Ellen Villa Appeal wig, which is a human hair wig that I won from Ellen Villa. And I reviewed that one. And I just got this Gardeau little bob, really cute wig. I should go get that and show it to y'all. And I'm wearing that one a lot. And who else do I wear a lot? I still wear my Ellen Villa United, but her fibers on, you know, down around the nape have gotten kind of tangly and not thrilled with it. So she's kind of become an at-home wig. I do wear that Hannah by Envy. That was the one that I had the love-hate with. I wear it out a little, like errand running, that kind of thing. I did wear it to teach my kiddos on Wednesdays. I work with a group of kids on Wednesdays. And I did wear it to that. That's with my Bible study. So I did wear it to that one day, and it was fine. I still just, the lace on that thing is itchy. And after I've had it on for a while, I'm just like, I want to take it off and claw my forehead. So that's why it's kind of an at-home wig, and I shared all the issues I had with it. So other than that, I have some others that are just occasional ones. Like I occasionally wear my Raquel Welch Simmer. I haven't reviewed this yet, but I do wear a Gabor Halo wig. It's called Gabor Halo. I can't remember. It's in the shade 829 Hazelnut. I wear that thing with a cap. I wear that almost every day. I wash it a couple times a week because I walk in it outside. I exercise in it. And I can put it in a ponytail, put on a cap, and it's awesome. I need to review that one and show it to y'all because I've tried some other like halo type wigs for hats, and this one is awesome. I think those are the main ones that I have an Aesthetica Ellis in R628, and I'm going to do a color review on that one. And, because I've already reviewed Ellis, but I really like that one too. That's a great color. I love that Raquel Welch Flirt Alert that I just reviewed. But I do have a friend who wanted that one, so I think I'm gonna sell it to her. So I think I think it's a gorgeous wig and I love it. I would have kept it, but like I said, it's one of those things where somebody asked me and I was like, you know what? Sure, I'll sell it to you. You know. Other than that, my reviews can be seen here on my channel, and they can also be, some of them can be seen on the Wig Studio One channel. Subscribe to them too, because Taz's Wig Closet reviews there, Wigging with Christy reviews there, Denise Sheets reviews there, I review there, Michelle Pearl, they just did a review for them. Trista's Tresses reviews, but I think she's taking a little break right now. Bren, Fake Hair Real Talk with Bren, she reviews there too. So lots of reviewers, lots of a great opportunity to see wigs on a lot of different faces, face shapes, and head sizes and stuff. So anyway, I guess I will shut this down with, as we are almost at the 20-minute mark, and that is probably enough talking from me for today. So I just, again, thank you so much for watching my reviews. Thank you for coming to this channel. Thank you for subscribing. I appreciate that. And until next time, don't forget, you're absolutely beautiful. Have a great day. Bye.